Hi guys, so I'm Dr. Zainab Bora, your educator for radiology on the Unacademy platform, and I'm here with the third part of the series on A to Z syndromes with the letter C. And it is a coincidence that all of these are very, very important, all right? So the syndromes that we're going to discuss, please pay some special attention here for the exam going students. So let's begin. So the first one that we have is a disease called as Caffey's disease. Now Caffey's disease is also called as infantile cortical hyperostosis, and that in itself tells you a lot of information about this disease. So this is infantile cortical hyperostosis. So what is the age group? It affects the infants. So it is seen in less than 1 year old children, and they typically present with fever, irritability and soft tissue swelling. So this is the clinical triad that you can expect to see here, or like, so fever, irritability and soft tissue swelling is what these kids will present with. When you do their x-ray, what will you find? Cortical hyperostosis, or basically reactive periosteal thickening. All right, so periosteal thickening is what is noted on the radiographs, and the bones which are the hallmark, the most common bone which is affected is shown to you here, which is the mandible. So can you see this thickening, cortical thickening and the periosteal reaction around the mandible? So this is the hallmark. So remember, the most common bone to be affected in Caffey's is the mandible. Alright, so this is something which is important. And also remember, this is not a septic osteomyelitis. It is an inflammatory disorder, but aseptic. Right, so this is Caffey's infantile cortical hyperostosis, mandible, clavicle, two most common bones involved. Next, we have three psychiatric syndromes. All right, so I have brought Fregoli just because it is a mimic of Capgras. All right, so Capgras syndrome, how do we remember this? So here, this is a syndrome of misidentification, wherein what do you do? So from the word Capgras, I want you to just remember crap. All right, so crap, my family has been replaced by a stranger. All right, so suddenly you walk into your house and you feel like all your family members have been replaced by strangers. So you would be like, oh crap, what has happened? Right, so this is how I want you to remember Capgras, that when you mistake your family for stranger. All right, so everybody looks like a stranger to you. The exact opposite is Fregoli. So F for Fregoli, F for everybody is my family. So you would feel that every stranger is your family. All right, so this is how you can remember Capgras and Fregoli, and believe me, like, students confuse this like the most. All right, so just remember these two syndromes, and just because we have the letter C, we have another syndrome of psychiatry, which is the Cotard syndrome. It's also called as a syndrome of nihilism. Right, so here there is basically associated depression and the feeling that you do not exist. Right, so all of these patients will stop eating completely because they do not believe that they are alive. All right, so remember, this is Cotard syndrome, a syndrome of nihilism. Going ahead to three carnies, again very, very important. So what is the typical carny triad? So what you are seeing here is the carny triad. So what do you see in the lung? A popcorn lesion, a well-defined lesion with calcification. So this is the pulmonary hematoma or the pulmonary chondroma. Here in the stomach, a very, very aneurysmal wall thickening when you see with central necrosis. This is a gastrointestinal stromal tumor. Carotid body tumor, which is also called as a paraganglioma, right? So carotid body tumor is a paraganglioma, an extra-adrenal pheochromocytoma here situated at the carotid bodies playing the ICA and the ECA. So this is a paraganglioma. So the triad of hematoma, GIST, paraganglioma is the Carney's triad. When we talk about the Carney's Trataskis dyad, remember the things which have a G in them. So GIST and paraganglioma are Carney's Trataskis dyad. When we talk about Carney's complex, it is something entirely different, right? So here you would have multiple myxomas, predominantly atrial myxomas are associated here. You would have endocrine abnormalities like Cushing syndrome, and there would be multiple cutaneous pigmented lesions. All right, so cutaneous pigmented lesions would be the third thing. So this is about Carney complex, and also remember, associated with this are Lamb syndrome and something called as Name syndrome. So these are associated syndromes with Carney complex. Looking at the next one, which is Castleman disease, again very, very important. So this is basically a lymphoproliferative disorder, a B cell mediated lymphoproliferative disorder, wherein two types you need to know. So there are two types clinically, two types pathologically. So clinically, when it's a single nodal disease, all right, so when you have a unicentric disease where a single lymph nodal mass is enlarged, this is most commonly seen in the mediastinum. This is something which is seen in younger adults. All right, on the other hand, when you have a multicentric disease wherein multifocal lymph nodes are enlarged, this is typically seen in patients who are HIV positive and patients who are older, and this has a higher association with the HHV8 virus. All right, how does it look imaging wise? So imaging wise, Castleman appears as a hypervascular lymph node. All right, so when you see that a lymph nodal mass is enhancing too much, so much that it actually mimics paragangliomas a lot of time in the mediastinum. All right, so remember this presence as a hypervascular, very, very enhancing nodal mass. On the other hand, when we talk about the pathological appearance, there are again two types. One is the hyaline vascular type, wherein you would have the vascular proliferation, and the other is the plasma cell infiltrating variant, alright. And the unicentric type is more commonly the hyaline vascular one, and that also explains the hypervascular nature, okay. So this is briefly about Castleman disease. Remember, all the lymphoproliferative disorders like Kikuchi, Kimura disease, Rosai-Dorfman, all of these are very, very important, okay. Going ahead. Chidiakigashi, a syndrome of immunodeficiency. So here how I want you to remember this is LMNOP. Alright, so this is what is our mnemonic here. So from L, three things I want you to remember. One, what is the associated skin abnormality? So we would have the patients being light. So we have associated albinism, right? So first feature, albinism. Second, the gene which is affected, LIST. Alright, so LIST is affected, and the third thing, histopathologically, there would be again lymphohistiocytic infiltration. Alright, so that is the third L I want you to remember. When we talk about M, what does the LIST gene control? So it controls the microtubular movement. So remember, there is a problem with the microtubular movement here. Going on to N, what is the problem with N? Two very, very important things. One is neutrophils. So what do you see in the third image here? That the neutrophils have these giant granules. So there will be these giant granules that are seen with neutrophils. Again, the neutrophils will be less effective in their function, which leads to a higher chance of infection. Along with that, very, very important, there is associated neuropathy. Okay, so this is something which is quite typical for Chidiakigashi. And with O, I want you to remember, although it starts with a P, remember phagolysosome. So lots of O's roaming around. So phagolysosome formation here is impaired. All right, so that is the pathophysiology. And with P, I want you to remember platelet dysfunction. All right, so there is platelet dysfunction and also associated thrombocytopenia. All right, so this is how we remember Chidiakigashi, LMNOP. Finally, we have Caroli's disease. So for Caroli's disease, I want you to remember one thing. It is a type 5 polydocal cyst wherein you have dilatation of the intrahepatic biliary radicals. All right, so intrahepatic involvement only, and the sign that we have here is the central dot sign. So this is the central dot sign that I want you to remember, and it is basically the portal veins, all right, which are seen within the dilated biliary radicals. And just for an extra edge, remember this is a type of a ductal plate malformation. So there's a theory which is basically for all the cystic lesions of the liver, which is called the ductal plate malformation, and this is something which is belonging to that. Going ahead to the last one, which is the CHARGE syndrome. So you just need to know the acronym here in the CHARGE syndrome. So C for coloboma, all right. So C for coloboma of the eye, H for associated heart defects. A, what do you see here in the CT? You see that there is choanal atresia, right? You can see a membrane which is blocking here. So A for choanal atresia. R for growth retardation. Alright, so R for growth retardation, G for associated genital anomalies, and E for ear anomalies. All right, so this is how you have to remember the CHARGE syndrome. All right, so these were all the important syndromes. I believe all of these are very, very important with the letter C. I'll see you all tomorrow with the letter D and the various syndromes associated. So I hope this was useful, and please drop your feedback. This just pushes me to work harder. So thank you so much, and see you guys.